Well, greetings, Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope. Well, we can finally say goodbye to having the responsibility of having the sun in the first house. Now, your sun's in the second house. And sun in the second house, that's the best time to sing spiritual songs and elevate the heart that way. I think that's a good idea. Mercury's still in the first house, but life is making sense now that it's going direct. Everything's working out, moving forward. You survived the lunar eclipse and the solar eclipse, and unfortunately some people didn't survive it, and we mourn their losses. I've seen a lot of loss this year, and my only conclusion to that is I know that when those things happen, usually socially, we're about to make a quantum shift, folks, and we can't hang on. We're going to have to let go and let the breeze take us, stay in our love, stay in our hearts. That's the message, Sagittarius. And right now it's like listen twice, speak once. Jupiter is in your sixth house. Do things to improve your health. Do things to fortify your immune system. Do things to feel better. Mars is in your midheaven, so you have a certain sense of authority right now and a certain drive to be athletic and strong and a dynamic leader who's ready to chase the devil. It's like a Max Romeo song, I'm referencing that for you, Sagittarius. Max Romeo, I'm not sure if he is. He's close to Sagittarius. He's November 22nd, but I was born in 44 in Jamaica, man. I think he might be Scorpio. I'm sure. But, nevertheless, you'll relate to it.